Okay, hopefully my internet is working now. Kind of weird, that's been happening to me a couple days now. Maybe this phone's just getting free, it's just gonna explode or something. Oh well. Seems like it's working. Okay, let's start this. Let me see if it's working. Okay, there we go. Okie dokie. So I guess we'll start off with this verse again. And whatever so ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Colossians 3:17. Okay, let's see. Get on another scripture. Let's see. Sometimes I like doing the random scripture thing, and the you just add this random thing on my phone, and I just click it, and it just puts out a random Bible verse, you know? Whoever gives thought to the word will discover good. And blessed is he who trusts in the Lord. A worthless man plots evil, and his speech is like scorching fire. This was Proverbs chapter 16, and the first one was 20, and then the second one was 27. Okay, I guess we'll do a card reading. Okay, let's see here. It is cold in here, man. I guess gotta get moving. Up. Man, after doing all that perspective study, man, it's really very, very interesting thinking about like the perspective stuff now. Yeah, it's kind of weird. But see, there's like some axis where, like, I don't see where that one. Oh, I guess it'd just be straight up. Okay, yeah, that would just be straight up and down. Yeah, very, very interesting, you know? Doing all that perspective study, like, I think what's weird is I've noticed a lot of people's perspective drawings, and I think the one thing that trips people out is, like, you know, the vanishing points, how there's the vanishing points. It seems like so many. I do it too. I do. I'm not saying I don't do it, but I do it probably more than anybody. And it's like the thing is that I always line everything up to that one vanishing point. But the thing is when you look at reality, it's basically every, the va once you have the horizon line, everything's just off of that. You know, and there's so many like things that tilt and turn and twist and like it's very. It's a trip. It really is. Okay, anyway. Keep thinking. I'm like, I've been on like a drawing thing. It's so strange. I literally took a 6 month break from drawing. Like, I was like burnt out. I mean, I don't know. It was weird. And now I'm like obsessed about it again. It almost feels like I'm like back into drawing. It's really cool. Orem chant. Yeah, the longest break I've ever taken, actually, from drawing in my entire life, I think. Like, I literally. Ooh, I love this one. Selfless Exorcist. Christopher Muller did an amazing job on this one. I love how solid it is. His shadows are just like very, very confident. And that's hard to do. Three. Island. Four. And this one again. Hidden Ancients. The Trents. The Ents are alive! Four. Five. Deft Duelist. That's the other thing. Like, another thing actually I like about... That's actually very strange. Every single one of these has been a traditional painting. But, that's another thing I like about doing the traditional art. Especially, like, just drawing on paper. Is because, like, in the back of my mind, I always think, man, if, like, humanity were to collapse, and, like, you know, the infrastructure of, like, energy and all that stuff, you could always probably, I mean, you could even draw a piece of charcoal from a fire pit. You know, and draw on stuff like that, on a cave or something like that, you know? But, yeah, so I kind of like having that thought in my back of my mind. Man, every one of these has been a traditional painting. I love this one, Regenerate. One, two, three, four. Let's see. Another this one come out. I think this one is a digital painting. Oh, no, I think this one actually might be another traditional painting. I have a lot of traditional paintings. Now that I realize it, I'm like really like, dude, that one looks like a trip. I have not like really, I don't know. Sometimes you pick up those cards and you're just like, you haven't seen them in a while and you're like, what in the world, bro? It's like a little portal, man. Like I've had some trips, man, and I'd break out these cards or just even look at some paintings. And dude, it's like you're entering a little portal. Two, three, four. Okay, last card. Okay, Kite Sail. Kite sailing is a way of life, and without practice, the end of it. And that, ladies and gentlemen, was the draw for the bike stream. Now, let's see here. Let's put on some music. We need some like just some good tunes, man. Let's go back to just like this one. Just the old surfing music. Actually, I haven't really ridden with these gloves.
You know what? That actually makes me wonder. I thought, like, when did the wetsuit come out for, like, surfing, you know? Because I bet, like, when surfing came out, like, they weren't even using wetsuits, man. Dude, it must have been so cold for them, bro. Dude. My fingers are frozen. It's snowy outside. I just gotta warm up. I just gotta get my body moving. Starting to finally get the fire hydrant. This might be the first day I've ever landed one, just first try. If you look back maybe about 3 weeks ago, I literally was taking like 30 tries just to land one. Weird, it's like, I guess it's not that cold. You can't even see my breath. I don't know why I'm so cold today. That's what I was practicing. Practicing two with my cable normal. kind of style of music is this? This is just like... This is surfer music. It's like...
Yeah, I like the drums. I like it all, honestly. It's cool. Some fire hydrants to switch or stick these. That's a hard one, man. Let's see how they're doing it. I've seen like two people do it. So they do a fire hydrant, and when it goes right here, they get onto the back peg. Into the... Hard to aim at. I need to tighten my wheel. Guess I might as well just do that now. I don't want to ovalize it. Thank you.
These are legit. I want to get one of those ones. Those ones are gnarly. I forgot that's actually another one. Things are gnarly.
Okay, let's fix my bike. Some Loctite or something on there. Oh, maybe that's what it was. Maybe my peg was just loose. Let's see if that was it before I try. Maybe that's what all it was. Hey, let's just loose. Yeah, huh. I guess my peg was just loose, man. I guess it's a little bit loose. It's not that bad. There's an old one. Huh. Let's just keep riding. There's another way to get into it too. I should be practicing the other ways to get into it. Way where you just like you can just get into it from the manual. That's what I think, right? So. to the back here. I guess, like, you have to lean like that. I shouldn't even be learning the glide. I need to just be learning the scuff. Yeah, I need to just learn the scuff. Let's listen to this. Figure invention with Jeff Watts. Try and learn the backyard.
Classes, which is
That's why I'm taking. So today it's books that helped me learn how to draw the human figure in dynamic ways. Because I mean,
get up.
Sometimes sensationalized figures. So, you know, with that, with Avatar the Marvel way, you've got us, you know, basically you got Stan Lee and John Michelle.
Oh, you're going to go to bed.
I did.
And just the things I noticed with things like this is not only the volumetric strength, but how he tweaks it on the knee, squares it off, cuts it presented as the same thing, how he does little skinny ankles, it makes the calf look bigger, the knee looks tight, the quads look bigger. So the joints are very specifically designed to make the muscles look more heroic. And so when you're doing that, like whether it's a male or female, the females can be a little different. But these mannequins, like he goes from where he goes from really wireframe, more of a cylindrical, kind of bendable wireframe of geometry, and to ultimately the form, and then on the form would be fleshed out with proper lighting, which this one does not have, for example. But the ability to do that, that's something that just takes hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of drawings, copying from good guys, going back and trying to do it yourself. Sketchpad pages like this that I have. These are some Buscema drawings and some other things. I'm not sure where all of them are from. Some of them, I maybe got them off of Instagram from a
sculpture. Oh my goodness.
Sculpture that was awesome that
I can't tell you.
And I would just do a sketch of it, but I would stylize. I always put it through my own filter of stylization, which comes from all the things I'm going to be talking about right here. So when I draw, I think about mannequinizing, I think about the abstraction.
Then you just like go like that.
I think it's like a kid's book, like all that was like something you would draw in, I don't know, elementary school or something. And it's timeless really. Because you can call like $1 million. Some of the best draftsmen I know exist in the movie industry, the comic industry, animation industry, and you don't normally see their work because their work is probably, you know, ownership of those companies.
I've never seen that one before.
But they're awesome. So this one is, again, has mannequinizing in it. It's well done. It's got some really good information. You know, I don't go to Hampton for finishes. None of this is finished stuff. This is all how you think stuff, right? So another book of an ex-student of mine who was with me for 13 years, pretty much trained him from very early on, was Ron Lemon. And Lemon did an awesome job in the FX magazine years ago. I think you might still get this if you look it up, but it was an Anatomy Essentials issue. And I took it and actually cut it up and just wire bound it because it's a lot of good, really good information in here. And a lot of this information is built off of things that I kind of talked about the writing method, things he extrapolated.
Maybe you have to take your arms off to do that.
It dovetails nicely with Hampton. It's got some of the same information. All of us are all borrowing concepts from other guys we know, and then we're tweaking them a little bit, putting our own twist on it. So the information is not really like copyrighted information, it's simply concept information on how to wedge the body, how the obliques wedge with the epigastrial section of the abdominal, how the pecs work around that, how the rib cage stretches in. So when I say stretch, it's how it interacts into like elevating
Oh, interesting.
Three-dimensional form, whether it's through...
Never heard about that guy. Don't know how they're doing it. Let's see, where is he putting his foot? How is he? I don't see how they're turning like that. Oh, maybe that's what I'm doing wrong. Okay, yeah, I think I'm getting something wrong up in here. His entire leg's behind his seat. Very bizarre, huh? Oh, interesting. It's also... Okay, his foot is actually curved that way, huh? That's another one I didn't really realize. It's strange that his leg is, like, all the way curved like that. I think I got my leg position wrong. Okay, so if you guys are having trouble, like, if you guys are learning the backyard, like, I'm doing it weird. This one dude has a seat behind his leg, but when they're gliding it, it's like they don't have their seat on their leg. So when they're gliding it like this, but when they're scuffing it, it seems like they have their knee on, or something like that, behind their seat.
Guy. I mean, that's
start turning.
Like him, probably sitting down and just spitballing, right? I got
I'm gonna do this straight a lot. Cool seeing he's still making videos, still drawing. It's awesome. Oh man, I forgot to put it. I need to do that right now, actually. These gloves are tight. The update. That's 18 more. Pinky. On the pinky. Wait a minute, I have two of those. No, why is there two of them? I gotta delete that. Wait, can I do it in here? Schnackles, I gotta change something real quick.
Somebody got uploaded twice.
Okie dokie.
Okay, we actually have a lot. Actually, a little worried. I was like, what in the world? We ran out. But nope. We still got it. Okay.
Apologies if this is really boring to watch. It probably is. I'm just trying to learn this new trick. And this trick in particular, it's like many other flatland tricks. It's just one of those ones where it's like you basically have to live in this strange position for like so long and then until you just finally start getting comfortable with it. And this is one of those ones that are, it's very, very hard for me. It's the backyard. I'm trying to learn how to turbine it because I would just go straight, but I don't have that much room in here. And unfortunately, the turbine, doing it in a circle is kind of like going a couple steps ahead, because doing it in a straight line is always easier. But because I don't have that that room, I'm trying to skip ahead to where I really should be trying it. I'm trying to just learn how to do it in a circle, basically. He is taking his hands off when he's doing it, so maybe that's what I gotta do. It seems like his foot's like... maybe his foot's like that. Oh, no, that's gonna get caught. That's the other thing that's, I think, really hard about this is I'm having to fight having my foot get caught in here. You have to take my hands off. Maybe that might be missing. It's very strange how it's going in a circle. We'll just keep observing. I wonder, like, I wish there was more videos to see how what they're doing. I'm having to, like, take it from, like, well, not take it, but, like, observe it from, like, one rider right now. I'm wondering, like, who else... does it? See, he's turning even before he takes his hands off. Like, okay, he has that arc right off the bat. Oh, there's that other thing. His foot is on that side of the tire. Interesting. So maybe I have to do that as well. When he's doing it, his foot... put on here. Still, I've been trying to do it on the top. He's aiming on the side.
Right, so we've got different iterations of mannequinization, which is built off of
smaller.
I could be annoyed by the people next to me, they're kicking my seat, or whatever, the kid that's crying at the left ear, or whatever. Why they sit and draw something, right? I got 3 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours of time just to completely immerse myself and get some quality sketching done. And I think it's a fantastic use of time, right? You also can have your iPad there, just bring it up, you know?
Wow. He has so many more videos now. I've been digging this a lot lately.
Okay, so I have a littler pedal on now.
I
crank keeps hitting my leg. I mean, what I could do, I might put just another link in my chain just so I could have it more back. I might have to do that actually. My heel's totally at the end, but that would just be so unruly. Maybe that's how I have to do it then. I literally had to have my heel. Normally, like, people have it like this. You have to be like that, maybe. Oh, maybe that's how I can do it, like that. Time to maybe try this tape out now that I got. Skateboard tape. I kind of feel like it's not going to work with my phone. It might work. It's going to mess up my stupids. The other thing that's messing me up is I'm not running a free coaster. I do have a free coaster, but it's like the wheel's all messed up. It's all like loose or something. I don't know what's wrong with it, but it still kind of works. But it's also, there's a lot of slack in it. And I don't like it. Like, I kept hitting my knee on the stem and shit. So normally, if you're a free flatlander, you're normally riding a free coaster. I can't do it, man. I've ridden the cassette too long, I think. Actually, crazy.
think it actually might work. I keep like trying to do it like on the side. Should be doing it like that. That's hard. That's how it should feel. I'm just gonna push through my calf with the crank. Get it to work, I think. Okay, you can get it to work. Like barely. Smaller cranks, man. I also need to bring my arm up with that. This trick is ridiculous, man. I think I can even do it. I just want to turbine it. I want to turbine it. I might not be able to turbine it, honestly, without a free coaster. I'm like trying to figure it out, but I don't think it's gonna go down. Maybe.
Yep.
to take your hands off. I think that's the thing. I think you might have to take your hands off, because I've been, like, scared. I've been, like, trying to, like hold it, you know? Because when you're gliding it, you can hold on. You know, you can hold on. But if I want to turbine it this way, I need to have, and the thing is since I'm running a cassette, every time it goes back, see if I have my foot, I should have my foot like this. This is how everybody has their foot. Normally like this. But with a cassette, see how it like hits my leg? So I'm having to do it on my heel like this. So I can have room. But because of that, it's changing a lot of this geometry. So I think I need to even be more in front of the bike. So I have to like maybe take off my hands and like lean forward to get that next push into that round. Oh, actually, that's the first time I ever got into it. Okay, all this practice is not for nothing. I'm improving a little bit. This trick is freaking hard, man. This one's been a challenge for me. I've given up on it many times. This is another one I've given up on. But I feel like if you just think you're just gonna live like this, in this position, and you just get comfortable with it, you're gonna start learning all the ins and outs. What did they do? I think they even sit on their seat. It's awesome making little milestones. No, I haven't landed it. I'm getting a little bit more comfortable, and that's what's cool. It's not as stressful. It's not like, you know, make me this confused. That's cool.
Okay.
kind of wondering if there's a way I could get out of it. Kind of wondering, can I just... Oh, wait, yeah, you can. This is an interesting one. Let's listen to this guy. I'm kind of digging this, like listening to our videos while I'm trying to learn how to do stuff. Multitask. He's doing it differently. And I do it. I guess maybe, so that's the other thing, is I've kind of stopped watching a lot of drawing stuff because I kind of wanted to go off on my own little, you know, realm. And sometimes when you watch and like learn from a lot of other people, you start picking up what they do. And I've been kind of wanting to go like, you know, off on the thing, on my own. Thing, but maybe I might listen to this guy. Karl Kopinski. Karl Kopinski is an awesome cyclist.
Karl Kopinski is back with a demo from Imagine Nation. Here we go. People always seem to draw to my line works, and it's quite nice to have an outlet for it, you know, Instagram. I'll tell you what I've found as well with paints. Same stuff, great ideas, great.
to a cedar, you just go like that, and then...
design choices. But just by doing these sort of initial kind of loose lines, I can often come up with something that's maybe changes the silhouette a little bit, or can inform the structure of if he's wearing armor, or, you know, whatever it may be. So I quite like that idea, just to change it up a bit, keep things fresh. It's essentially just gestural marks, you know, but if you can get them to have a
yep, yep. What's Spencer Forsman doing, man? What's your oldest video? Let's see. When do you start vlogging? You started vlogging a long time ago. I think I need to. I need to tighten my wheel. It's a little loose.
I gotta take my plate off. Okay, let's see if we can type this thing. Oh, my crank is tight. It's not like I'm really doing crank flips, honestly.
We'll try again. We'll make Jay do a good hang five trick for you guys real quick before we end the video. You gotta do the windshield wiper.
To turbine BMX. Triple turbine, no handed hang time, Messiah. Which way was he hang time? Good at the one-handed hang fire. My chain's too tight. I guess I'm not. Oops. Oops. Let's see here. How long have we been streaming for? It's been 2 hours. 2 hours. I kind of want to draw, man. I might get back in the draw. Let's keep going.
Okay, everybody, welcome. This is going to be a really, really fun phase. I've been looking forward to this for quite some time. This is inking, and inking is a very broad subject. It's a subject that encompasses, brush, quill, ballpoint pen, and it can be also sumi brush inking. Graphic brush inking. There's all kinds of ways to do inking. Inking's been a very popular medium for centuries. Extremely popular towards the end of the 1800s when you had people like Joseph Clement Cole. Some of my favorites, Franklin Boone, Murray, Edwin Austin Abbey, G.D.S. Frazetta, and then you get into more modern like Frazetta and Branson and all these guys. So, love traditional inking. This, I'm going to go through some samples just to kind of get inspired and excited about this medium. Start with the most simple of the three tools we'll be using, which is ballpoint pen. Then we'll move to quill, then we'll move to brush, and we'll marry the two together, and we'll have a nice understanding of the value of inking. Inking is really a calligraphic medium. It's also a very forgiving medium, one of the most unforgiving you can't erase, similar to watercolor or the other one. And so it cultivates a directness in the way you work, a design on the fly kind of calligraphy. So this is a really wonderful opportunity to train the medium. The medium, I kind of liken it to Latin. It's kind of a dead language, but it's a very helpful language. So we don't want, I see very few people teaching it anymore. I see very few people.
I know, nobody freaking does the inking stuff, man.
So my goal will be to bring to you about 30 hours of inking demonstration of everything that I can think of that I've learned over the last 30 years or so. So I think it's not my primary medium.
Look at this.
Here.
figure out how I can.
Land it like that. I've never seen anybody do it like that.
Yeah.
toss.
Maybe that's what you can do. You can pull it right there.
Shepherd slinging.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jeff. You're a cool dude. Holy moly. Feel like I should be drawing right now. So that's actually pretty gnarly because both of these days, wow. That's gnarly, that was random. Dude, that is gnarly, what in the world? In the world, you have a cement vert ramp in your backyard.
Nobody likes waiting around for a device to connect. But with the HP Plus smart printer, a connected device is waiting for you.
Nice one.
HP Plus.
Drawing skate parks might be interesting too. Arcs.
This ramp was like done in 99, and then there was that time, it was like 2011, it was like, okay, let's relayer it again. I was like, man, I'm gonna keep doing that forever. I reached out to Hubbard and Grindline, and it's like, all right, I think we can do this, and they're like, yeah, man, that'd be awesome. Yeah, actually, you know, one of the best molds, it's already all there. And the transitions are like a little smaller than the standard version now. It is small, it is a big mold, but it's like small trains and verts.
Dude, that's so gnarly. Dude, they literally concreted his vert ramp. That is ridiculous, dude. Dude, I can't imagine having that in your backyard. That'd be so crazy. I can't believe he's not even wearing a helmet. Wow, dude. That was amazing. Cherry, bro. That was so good. Wow, holy Toledo. Oh, there's nets, so if he falls, you go into the net. I was like, dude, what happens if you fall in there? I can't believe this dude's still skating. Bomb Burnquist, man, he's a legend.
That's gnarly.
Dude, he has a freaking Olympic torch, man. That's brutal. I'm getting defeated by this trick.
The back you heard.
How do you guys learn it, man? So weird to chime in. You gotta like pull it out and then in like that. Yeah, because if you're turbining it, that's actually the way you could probably do it. Because then you just pull it down like that. I guess the only problem with it is, maybe if I do it, I gotta land on my front peg. Like that. That's the way to get out of it, easy.
I mean, this sounds good.
let's practice some locomotives. Bike feels solid, though. It sounds solid. Nothing's rumbled.
That's nice, having your bike solid. Is this thing on still? Oh, yeah, it is. Okay.
Maybe I should put it on a free coaster. My gosh. What? I should really probably put it on a free coaster. Try and draw some more bikes. I might as well, yeah. I feel like if I start drawing bikes, it might keep me in drawing longer. Because I got burned out doing the other stuff, so like, if I just try and draw more bikes. Yeah. That's what we're gonna do. Tuesday. Okay, I'm gonna read a scripture. Actually, let's do an MTG, and then I think I'm gonna do a drawing stream. The thing about the streaming, it's kind of weird. It's like, sometimes, like, you just don't want to do it, you know? Like, you don't want to click the button. But the thing is, right when you click the button, it really gets you to do things, you know? I feel like if I didn't click the go live thing, like, I'd be way more lazy, you know? Like, I wouldn't want to do, like, I'd probably just be shifting on the internet a lot more. So that's kind of the good thing about streaming. It keeps you, like, wanting to do things. Okay, first card. Ooh, sweet. Avison, Angel of Hope. Second card. What is this card again? Tranquil Garden. They're Heavenly Blade Master. Fourth. Brilliant Halo. Fifth. Kite Sail. Sixth, Griffin Guide. Seventh, Cradle of Vitality. 8th. Wow. I drew 3 angels today. We're in this hand. Seraphia, Sky's Blade. That was a very interesting hand right there. I normally don't draw that many angels. I think there's one other angel in there. Oh, no, there's actually a bunch. Never mind. Okay, we'll do that. Let's see. But many that are first shall be last, and the last shall be first. Matthew 19:30. Anyway, another kind of a short bite stream. Been kind of taking it a bit more easier this week. Anyway, farewell. I'm gonna probably do another drawing stream here pretty soon.